Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, we look at how we can use PuTTY on a Kali Linux machine to remotely connect to a Linux device. Now I'm on my Kali Linux device here, and I have PuTTY open, and we can use this to do a remote connection using SSH. For example, I already have a session that I've saved here, test one. If I click on it, I can log into this device, and I'm logged into this Ubuntu device. Now, there's other ways to use SSH to remotely connect to a device. However, you'll see that the default option of just going through the terminal doesn't give us too many options or features. For instance, you might not be able to change the font, or you might not be able to customize the background color and stuff like that, and you might not be able to save the user data like the username and the IP address. So if you're coming from like a Windows environment and you're used to using PuTTY for remote connections, you can still use it on Kali Linux. You just have to download the .exe file, and then you'll need to use Wine. So let's go through the process of how to do that. I'm gonna close this out. Now, like I said, we need a tool called Wine in order to open the .exe file, and you also need the PuTTY.exe. So you need to download PuTTY, so I will search for PuTTY download. And we'll go to this link that takes us to PuTTY.org and click on this option that says download PuTTY. Then if you scroll down, you'll see there's a PuTTY.exe. Just click on it and it should begin the download. Now it's a quick download. Okay. Once you have that downloaded, you can open your terminal. It should by default be downloaded into your downloads folder. So if you cd to your downloads folder and do ls, you'll see that you have it. So I already had PuTTY here, so it downloaded another one. Once you have PuTTY downloaded, you need to install Wine. So the command to install Wine is sudo apt install wine, and then put in your password. Okay, mine is already installed. And then the other thing you'll need to install is libwine, so sudo apt install libwine. Once you have those two tools installed, now you should be able to open PuTTY. Without them, you can't run a .exe file. Like I said earlier, the quickest way to SSH into another Linux device is to use SSH, then the username, and then the IP of the remote device, and then your password, and you're logged in. But as you can see here, we don't have an option to save the username or the IP address, and there's not too many features available for us. So in that case, if you, like I said, if you wanted to use PuTTY, you prefer using PuTTY, we can still use it here. So there's features available in PuTTY, like the ability to create new sessions and save the sessions. So let's open PuTTY here. We just type wine and then PuTTY.exe. That opens PuTTY for us. And I have a session that I've saved here. I can load it. And if you look at the settings, if you go to like data, you see I'm able to put in the username. Colors, you can change the background, like the default background. I changed that to this. You can change the font. I changed this to 18 points. So that's some of the features that you get with PuTTY. And if you needed to add a new session, you can add a new session here. You can, let's say email. Then you can save it, and now you have it. And you can go ahead and make changes to it. Let's say you wanted to change the font, you can come here and change the font. If you wanted to add like a username here, you can add a username, appearance, whatever you want to change, you can come in here and change it. Then you should be able to use it. Every time you need to log into that machine that you've saved, you just select it, select your session, click open, or you just double click on it. And it should open with whatever settings you have for that session. Now, for instance, as you can see mine here, I've changed the font, I've changed the background color and stuff like that. So that's all for this video. That's how we can use PuTTY on a Kali Linux machine to do remote connections to other Linux machine. So I hope this information has been helpful. I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks. Bye.